close the door quietly behind me. I don't want to wake up the neighbours. I got a big rucksack slung over my shoulders, but most of the gear is stashed in place. I step onto South Street and walk. The night is just what I wanted. Warm, dry, streetlight lit and clouded. A fox looks up from the bin bag it's been chewing and legs it down an alley. There's a row of drawn curtains to my left. At number 46, I creep through the gate and edge the garden gnome another half centimeter away from the door and keep walking. There are parked cars to my right. A few nights ago, half of them had their registration plates swapped around, but they're mostly back in their proper places now. Past white A4 papers taped to lampposts, blank except for the one word missing at the top. Come to the corner, the end of South Street, although words on a sign say instead that it's Fuck Me Avenue. The original got cut down, wrapped up and mailed free post to the customer services of some old bank. More parked cars and snoozing houses along Werewolf Lane. Past the white van that's been bubble wrapped, past number 68, whose occupants just got letters from skunk and white solicitors informing them their names would have to be changed. An acne of little toy green soldiers has broke out on the post box as here's your Church of Saint someone or other. Where its window was is instead a sign saying Free Cocoa Pops, inquire within. And some car on exclamation mark street ended up with a stained glass windscreen. Knights Templar, Holy Grail, Gnostic mystery clues are buried around here. Hermetic riddles to holy relics, to the authentic bones of the first person who ever said Christ on a bike. Past flamboyantly transvestite trees, up Inbred Avenue. One time I chloroformed this snoozing tabby cat here and gave it a pink Mohican. Past the Saint This Sucks school sign over the school fence, spiked rails with dangling banners telling you what shops you get vouchers from, but someone scissored out the supermarket logos and scrawled "The medicine is killing you" in black over their banners. Past the newsagents, a chain of adverts over its doorway. The sun, the sun, the sunk, the sun, the sunk, the sunk. And in the window, on little cards, exorcists advertise their services. Tutors want to learn your jibber-jibber languages. And there are magic beans for sale and entrail readings and pederasty lessons and lots of phone numbers. Past eyes painted on the pavement. I get to the end of Inbred Avenue and there's a sign. In a red-edged white circle, a red line is dashed through a black octagon. Here, the road goes left or right, but on the other side is a garage. Shell garage with the bushes behind it. One day I want to see all the police horses get free and gallop down this road. Over it, when the traffic light turns blue, or at one of these new zebra crossings that keep springing up. Anyway, there aren't any cars. I get to the garage. One day I want to see an inflatable Batman dangling noosed from this roof. I slip across the forecourt, spit on the petrol pumps and disappear in the bushes. Distant roads. In the daytime I could see the airport from here and golf courses around it. Occasionally the golfers' holes will somehow fill themselves with cement or dog shit. Now though, all I see is just the crops on both sides of me. This gold in the darkness barley reaching up almost to my shoulders as I step along one of two parallel lines left by a tractor along to the center of the field. Out of the rucksack comes a steel stick. The hard mud under me isn't that hard as I force this post down into it, down in the furrow left by a fat tire. And it stands there strong. Around its top is a slightly rusted hoop, a ring to which I attach the end of a chunky surveyor's tape measure. Yellow tape spools out as I carry that on along the track, meter after meter emerging from my steel post. A plane descends noisily overhead, but there's nothing to see here. 30 meters, the thin stems up to brittle tips. The weight of those pointed tops stoops the plants. They point downwards and sway in a slight breeze. And stashed among them, concealed within a cluster of trembling cereal grain, is this plank of wood. It's a meter and a half from left to right, with a rope through holes in both ends. I retrieve my plank and set it in place, looking out at 90 degrees from the tractor lines. And with a rope in one hand, as the other holds the tape measure straight, my right foot steps down on the wooden board, pressing down and sliding forwards as my left foot steps forwards, off the tractor track into the field, through the dense crops brushing my face and dying under my feet as I force the plank into and over them. The stalks are brought low and flattened as I push onwards, keeping the tape tight as 30 meters from me it loops slowly around the slightly rusted hoop. The yellow measure from there to here skims the soft spiked tops of the plants. They bend for it and spring back into place. The barley under me doesn't spring back into place. I plow forwards, facing away from the airport. Onwards, run, rabbit, run. Ahead of me, eventually, are those tractor lines. That path is path. I'm 60 meters down from where I started. And carry on, in the rustling and crunching, breaking crops, and on and round, facing the airport. And here's those tractor lines again, back where I started. I drop the board and the tape measure. I breathe deep and stretch. I'm aching, I'm sweating, but it's not over yet. I return along the track and unfix the tape measure from the metal ring, but attach it back onto the metal post. Then walk again and again, grip the rope and step again with the gear into the field. There's this new flattened path under me as I go, but now my surveyor's tape doesn't loop round the ring, but instead wraps around the pole. As I hold it straight, not pulling, not letting it slack, a yellow 30 meter radius becomes a 29 and a half meter radius. I glide off that last path and make another new one through the plants, again forcing forwards, sliding and pushing and occasionally having to kick the board over the barley. A 25 meter radius, further and further from my circle's edge as the tape wraps round and round the central post, drawing me round and round closer to it. I'm facing the airport, then facing away from the airport, back to the track and over it and into the crops and round again. 20 meters, 10 meters, the airport, then not the airport, the track, 5 meters of dwindling yellow, the airport, the crops, and here are those tractor lines with my stick spiked in this mud. No meters. The tape's all back in the tape measure, and there's only hard soil under the plank under my feet. I pack the tape and the dug up steel post into my rucksack, and the wooden board too, it pokes awkwardly out of the top, it looks conspicuous. But if anyone asks, I've got my cover story worked out, I've got reasons ready. I head back towards the garage. This is Dreamtime time. 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 This.